Good morning to everyone. My name is Francesco Breglia and I'm going to present the first attempt to formulate a Bronze Age paleo-environmental reconstruction of the Vallo di Diano by anthracological analysis. We are in southern Italy, precisely in Campania region. The Vallo di Diano is a large intermountain basin, which is one of the main natural transit routes through the southern Apennine chain. Indeed, its mean elevation is only 465 meters above the sea level, while the surrounding mountains reach the 2000 meters. This characteristic makes the Vallo di Diano an ecotone. In fact, despite its proximity to the Tyrrhenian Sea that you can see in the background, the mountain range here, this range, acts as a barrier. As a result, the Mediterranean and the temperate region meets here in a very peculiar way. So, basically, the valley bottom is a transition zone between the two macroclimate regions. Going up along the slopes of the mountain, the climate quickly assumes a temperate humid characteristic. The location of the sites we took into account in this work is here reported in red. In this slide, a geomorphological and a geological map of the area are shown. The Vallo di Diano has a tectonic origin. It is precisely an Halfgraben with a system of active faults along its eastern border here. And we know that this tectonic depression was once filled by a lake. Here are the lacustrine deposits. Starting at least from the lower Pleistocene, the Idric Basin lasted until the Holocene. Here you can see a simulation, or perhaps just a suggestion, of how the basin could have been in the past. We used a present-day relief model and applied the different lake levels, starting from an altitude of 495 meters to go down to the present valley bottom. Well, the question we asked to ourselves was, when did this lake disappear? Was it still present during the Bronze Age? The valley is now cultivated, but this is only possible thanks to a reclamation work. Today, a large canalization work drains the valley bottom. Nevertheless, in case of particular heavy rains, nature finds its way. This picture shows the result of 48 hours of non-stop heavy rain. Concerning the reclamation history, we know from the so-called Lapis Polle, an epigraph found in the Vallo di Diano, that in the second century before Common Era, a Roman road passed across the Vallo. Moreover, we know that in the same period, the public land was centuriated for farming. This aspect is also reported in the epigraph. The consul says that he was the first to ensure that shepherds were replaced by the farmers. This is not a declaration of war against shepherds. The expression probably refers to the first reclamation of the land, once used for grazing and now reclaimed and then arable. So, before the second century, the valley bottom must have been marshy, at least. In the 16th century, Leandro Alberti reports that near the town of Polla, a town into the valley, there was a swamp. And still, at the end of the 18th century, the problem was relevant. Carlo Afán de Rivera published a detailed work about the reclamation undertaken during the Bourbon dynasty. Okay, now that we have a clearer view of the context, let's make a very big step back in time. Here you can see the distribution of the late prehistoric and protohistoric sites in the Vallo. Going into details, in the Neolithic, we have just a sporadic presence in caves. The finds became fewer for the early Neolithic and completely absent for the middle part of this age. In a period between the end of the Neolithic and the beginning of the Bronze Age, there is a reoccupation of the caves and the settlement of an open-air village in Fossa Aimone. The Middle Bronze Age is the most attested period. The number of both cave and open air sites grow, but also the quantity of finds within the sites is far higher. Finally, in the late and in the final Bronze Age, we assist to a contraction of the number of the sites, in this case, probably connected to new settlement strategies not yet understood. The two main sites on which this work is based are Grotta di Pertosa and Grotta di Polla. These two caves are located in the northern part of the Vallo, and they are really near one to each other, but their climatic and environmental features are sensitively different. Grotta di Pertosa is located near the Tanagro River and at a lower altitude, but its exposure to north and the morphology of the slopes gives the area a mesotemperate humid climate, while near Grotta di Polla there are mesomediterranean conditions. The archaeological interest of Grotta di Polla is known since the end of the 19th century. When a Bronze Age pile dwelling settlement were found in the initial part of the cave and investigated during two excavation campaigns. Recent archaeological surveys in the 2004, 2009 and 2013 conducted by the CRS Enzo de' Medici brought to the discovery of 86 wooden poles in the riverbed area, six of which were dated and confirmed a Middle Bronze Age chronology. Moreover, the erosion of a mud bank by the stream exposed a layer rich in plant remains here, and the soil samples were collected. So far, we do not know if this layer is a dump or rather a collapsed floor of the pile dwelling. Anyway, a subsample was studied and a total amount of 114 charcoals were found and analyzed. Grotta di Polla is also a well-known site, at least from the 60s of the last century, when the archaeological investigation within the cave started. A long-time occupation was highlighted in the initial part of the cave, and we know that during the Bronze Age the cave was also used for funerary reasons. This was confirmed by the 2016 and 2017 University of Molise excavations. In a natural large niche located in an internal area of the cave, a funeral context dating back to the Neolithic Bronze Age transition period was found. Actually, at that time, this part of the cave was directly connected to the entrance of the cavity. It then progressively closed due to sedimentation. Two soil samples were collected in this area and 332 charcoals were analyzed. The third context we took into account is Grotta Maria Colombo. The site is located in the southern part of the Vallo at a definitely higher elevation compared to the other two caves. The site was recently discovered and investigated by an equipe from La Sapienza University and Roma Tre University. The results of the excavation are still unpublished, but we know that the cave was used for funerary reasons during the Middle Bronze Age. In our laboratory, six soil samples collected during the burials excavation were studied by Dr. Chiara Belli. In this diagram, we can see the result of the anthracological analysis. We grouped the found taxa into six different environment types: Hygrophilus forest, Garrig, Piedmont plain, woodland margin, mesophile woodland, and mountain forest. The three caves gave pretty different results. The Grotta di Polla sample show a prevalence of woodland margin vegetation with few Piedmont plain elements and a good representation of mesophile woodland and some mountain forest species. Actually, the presence of Pinus sylvestris nigra group in this sample could be probably related to lower altitude species instead of mountain ones. On the other hand, Grotta di Pertosa sample shows vegetational features clearly linked to mesophile woodland with few woodland margin and Hygrophilus forest elements, while Grotta Maria Colombo sample gave a marked mountain forest vegetation characterized by beech and conifers, in particular by the Pinus sylvestris nigra group. If we place this data on an altimetric scale, it's possible to notice how the results fit pretty well with the location of the sites. Concluding, this is the present-day land use map of the Vallo di Diano. We can point out some diachronical consideration if we compare this map with our archaeological data. Firstly, the valley bottom is today an arable land, while in the Middle Bronze Age, we said that was probably marshy and used for as a pastures, basically. The slopes around the main towns are occupied by crops and tree plantation. Here we have the sites. For example, in the area near Grotta di Polla and Grotta di Pertosa, here in the north, a vast chestnut wood replaced a natural mesophyll wood. Mixed wood and beech forest, basically in the tonality of green, are generally well preserved in the area, while coniferous mountain forest and pines in general are almost completely disappeared. Probably this kind of trees, so the conifers, were selectively cut in the past, maybe already during the Roman period. With this, I finished. Thank you for your attention.